So what? So let's dance.
Greetings, Dennis here. Thank you so much for tuning in to this week's video drum lesson. So this week I had a special request from a subscriber named Kimmy G for a song by Harry Styles called Only Angel. She wanted to learn how to play the song. I think a lot of people use YouTube for that purpose. They want to learn how to do something. It could be anything in the world. There's lots of videos on YouTube, but lots of people use it because they want to know how to do things. So this video is a drum lesson about how to play the song Only Angel by Harry Styles. So the first thing I do when I'm going to make a drum video or I'm going to learn a song for any reason is I make a cheat sheet. So a cheat sheet is just a basic outline of the song. So I go through all the parts of the song and I count out how many bars is each part of the song. So let me show you a view of my cheat sheet.
So here's the cheat sheet I made for Only Angel by Harry Styles. So I went through the song. The song's obviously in 4/4 time. It's a real groovy AC/DC kind of vibe. You know, it's rock, it's heavy, hard rock, but it's really groovy. So the intro is 9 bars. The first verse is 16. The first chorus is 9 bars. The second verse is 16, just like the first one. The second chorus is like a double chorus. So they're going to play that first riff twice. So it's 16 bars. Then there's a bridge, which is 16 bars. Then there's a third chorus, which is 16 bars also. And the outro is like the chorus, but there's no lyrics. So he doesn't sing the chorus lyrics. Instead, he kind of does some ad-libs. When you listen to the song, you'll see it. The intro is sort of the same way. And you can see I wrote those 3 eighth notes at the top. Those are pickup notes. So the song doesn't start on beat 1. It starts on the and of 3. And there's no count in. So when you listen to it, you'll hear what I'm talking about.
So let's start with that intro. The intro is the chorus guitar riff with no lyrics on it. And it starts with 3 pickup notes on the and of 3. So it really helps if you know music or rhythm well enough to know that eighth notes are counted 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So this song's going to count 1, 2, 3, dun, 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 that's the beginning of the song. It comes in on that riff. So I'm going to play along with it. You'll see me play along with it in a second. But I'm not going to play those pickup notes. There's no count in, so there's no way for me to know exactly where they're going to come in. So instead of playing them sloppily, I'm going to leave them out for this drum cover. If I was to play them in a live situation or with a band, there would be some kind of a count in or some kind of a click, and we would all know to come in on the end of beat 3. So it would be 1, 2, 3, dun, dun, dun. We could play that together. But let's check it out. Okay, so that rhythm, dun, 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 that comes back over and over again throughout this song. So he's going to use those hits to accent changes between one part and another, and he's going to use them to accent the lyrics in different places as well. So during this first verse, it's a 16-bar verse. I'm playing a broken hi-hat pattern with my right hand. I'm playing the and of 1, the and of 2, 3, and then 4 and. 2 and 4 on the snare drum, 1 on the kick drum, and of 3 on the kick drum. Every other measure, I'm going to open the hi-hat on the and of 4. The other thing you want to note about the verse is that in the middle of it, on the 8th bar, those hits come back. Dun, dun, dun. So you'll hear that, and I'm going to play that with the band. We'll accent those hits just like the drummer does on the track. So let's check out the verse. Open up your eyes, search your mouth and see.
I'm not afraid to die.
next we're going to play that first chorus. So the first chorus is the same thing as the intro, but he sings the chorus lyrics this time. It's important to note that the drummer accents those hits, dun dun dun, that come in on bar 4 and bar 6, and those are the most accented. So those are the ones that the drummer plays along with him. And then you're going to hear it again in the 9th bar, because that's where how the verse is going to start. So you're going to hear dun dun dun, and that'll be the second verse. Let's check out the first chorus. Okay, the second verse is pretty much like the first one. There's one notable difference, though, and that is that towards the end of the second verse, there's one bar of rest. So he's going to play the same verse riff, but on the 4th phrase, it goes right with his lyrics, right? So the lyrics, typically there's in the verses, there's 4 phrases, and then there's some hits, and then there's 4 more phrases before the chorus starts, right? So that 4th phrase, there's 4 phrases, there's some hits. On the 4th phrase, second time he's going through his rhymes, the 4th phrase, there's a rest. So we're going to stop everything. It accents his lyrics. And then some hits come in on end of 1, 3, 4, end. And I'll play them all with the band, and you'll see it. So remember to count. He's singing, and you're resting for 1, 2, 3, 4, one da 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 da. You'll see it when we check it out. Let's listen to it. Okay, second chorus is a double chorus, so it's twice as long as the first one. That makes it 16 bars. And remember that it's really just the same thing twice. It's 2 8-bar phrases back to back. They're the same. So we're going to play those hits. Dun, dun, dun. We're going to play them in bar 4. We're going to accent them in bar 4, I should say. And we're going to accent them in bar 6. And then we're going to do it again in bar 8 to start over. And that's going to happen twice. So you'll see it. And then I change it up during the second chorus. The drummer on the track goes to the cowbell. Now, I don't have a cowbell stand at this time. I was busking, and someone from the audience played my cowbell and lost my mount for me. Wasn't that nice of him? So I don't have one. So I'm going to play the ride cymbal bell instead of the cowbell. But you'll see it. So I'm playing quarter notes with my right hand on the ride cymbal bell. And I'm playing the same pattern I was playing during the verse. But I'm playing it with one hand. So I'm playing the hi-hat and the snare drum with one hand while I play the ride cymbal bell with the right hand. So this takes a little bit more coordination, but it rocks really hard. So it sounds great for this song. So let's check out that riff. Okay, next is the bridge. Now the bridge, this is a really AC/DC kind of bridge. This is exactly something they would do. So the volume comes way down. It's important to note that we're going to play softly. And the bridge is 16 bars. For the first 8, I'm just going to play 8th notes on the floor tom. So that's 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And I'm going to play quarter notes with my kick drum. So that's boom, boom, 3, 4, So that's the first half of the bridge, just that. And then during the second half, we're going to build up a little bit. So I'm going to add the snare drum on 2 and 4 during the second 8-bar half of the bridge. So we're going to add the snare drum on 2 and 4. We'll do that together. It's pretty easy to do. And then during the last two bars of the bridge, the drummer plays a dotted quarter note pattern, which means that you're going to play on 1, the and of 2, beat 4, the and of 1, second bar, and then 3 and 4 and. It's a really typical rock pattern. It's very common. It's like a really popular rhythm. You hear it in all kind of music. But anyway, it'll be real obvious. It'll be like ta do do ta do do ta do do ta do do ba ta ba ta. It'll be real obvious. That'll get us into the final chorus. Let's check out the bridge. Okay, next we're going to play the final chorus. Now this is also a double chorus, just like the second one, only we're going to up the volume and maybe play a few more drum fills, because this is like the climax of the song, right? Now remember, at the end of this chorus is the outro. The outro is just like the chorus, but there's no lyrics. So the singer does some ad-libs, same hits. You're going to really accent the and four and on bar 4, bar 6, bar 8, and then he adds an extra bar, so the bar 9 of the outro is going to slow down. So we're going to play the same hits, but we're going to play 3 and 4 and it will hold that 4 and that last note, and I hold that out with the cymbals. And if we were in a live setting, we'd probably play that and hold it out, and then we would cut together. There'd be most likely the band leader, the singer, would cue everybody when to stop, when to cut, or go to the next song. Something to make it exciting. So let's check it out. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you really enjoyed it and you would like to support my channel, you can make a donation via PayPal. I have a paypal.me link that I will post in the comments below. And I also have a Patreon account, which I will post a link to in the comments below. If you'd care to donate any amount, I would really appreciate it. That would be awesome. I also want you to know that I have a free drum lesson available at my website, dsnyderdrums.com. If you log in, enter your name and email address, you will receive my free video lesson and my ebook. So I'm available for lessons. If you want to, hit me up on my website. Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment below. Have an awesome day.